Let's discuss vertically scaling a graph. So we'll start off with a graph with some points, and that we'll call f of x. And in the table form, here we have the x values associated with its f of x, or its function values. Let's say we define another function g of x to be 2 times f of x. Well, that's going to do exactly what we expect. That's going to multiply all the y values by 2. So filling in this column, we're going to see the y values doubled. Now, before we look at this graphically, what if we also define a function h of x to be 1/2 f of x? Again, this will do exactly what we expect. It'll multiply all the y values by 1/2. Notice that the change is on the output. All right, so our outputs have been changed, nothing with the inputs. So let's look at what happens graphically. So we saw that this was our graph of f of x. Well, let's look at g of x, which was 2 times f of x. All the y values have been doubled. So this is what we call a vertical stretch, because it looks like the graph is being stretched away from the x-axis. Notice it still has all the same inputs, but all the outputs have been doubled. And that's whether they're positive or negative, so they're moving away from the x-axis. Now, when we multiplied by the 1/2, our graph looks like it was compressed towards the x-axis, because all of our y values have actually been cut in half. Thus, we call it vertical compression. And these are, again, changes on the output. They come from multiplying the function by some constant value. If the value is larger than 1, it stretches it. If it's in between 0 and 1, it compresses it. If it happens to be a negative value, then we have a reflection.